Hi, I am Mohammad Sfariza from Bachelor of Applied Science, Fisheries. My metric number is S50462. And I am going to present an article entitled Accumulation of Trace Metal in Anadara Granosa and Anadara in Aquivalves from Patani Bay and the Still Wetland. This article was published in the journal Bulletin of Environmental Contamination and Toxicology. The publisher for this journal is Springer New York from USA. The public rate in this journal was monthly. Meanwhile, the impact factor for this journal is 1.657 in 2019 and as much as 1.707 for 5 years. The ranking is Q2, which is pollution. The hedge index for this journal is 70, and the processing fee for published article will be charged as much as £2,180. For the indexing and abstracting, it was related to Science Citation Index Expanded, Agriculture, Biology and Environmental Science, Life Science, Biological Abstract, Biosis Previews, Essential Science Indicators, and Zoology Record. The main author of this article is Siripon Pradit from Prince of Songkla University, Thailand. The second author is Nur Azhar Muhammad Sazli from University of Malaysia, Terengganu, Malaysia, and followed by Pravit Tawatana and Wuttipong Sangmani from Prince of Songkla University, Thailand. This article was received in 21st July 2015 and accepted in 14th December 2015 by Springer Science Business Media New York 2015. For the background, the cockles, known as one of cheap source of protein and favorite seafood consumed by local in Thailand and Malaysia. However, the waste drained directly into the sea from industries and home contribute to the abundance of toxic metals in coastal habitat. Therefore, it may jeopardize human health by toxic effect due to the consumption of contaminated bivalves by their filter feeding mechanism. The objective of the study is to assess the level of trace metals such as arsenic, cadmium, copper, lead and zinc in two common species of Anadara granosa from Patani Bay, Thailand, and Anadara in Aquivalves from Still Wetland, Malaysia. Study results will be used as baseline of data for the present state of metal in cockles in the region. This is both of cockle species, which is Tegulaca granosa from Patani Bay, Thailand, and Anadara in Aquivalves from Still Wetland, Malaysia. This first research area is Patani Bay, which is located at southern part of Thailand, and the other one is the Still Wetland in Terengganu, Malaysia. For the materials and methods, samples of 120 individuals was collected in February and 80 in September for Patani Bay. Meanwhile, 90 individuals were collected at Still Wetland in February and 60 individuals in September. The sample then was kept in seawater for a day to purify their digestive tract and clean with mealy-cure water. All morphometric measurement was taken before the soft tissue was freeze-dried. To prepare the sample, 1.5 ml of HNO3 acid was used for acid digestion method. The sample then was drying in oven at 120 degrees for 7 hours before diluted 10 mL with deionized water. The analysis was conducted using Perkin-Elmer LN900 ICP-MS by muscle tissue BCR668 method accuracy verification. As the result, the biota sediment accumulation factor or BSAF for cadmium was higher in both sites, especially in September. However, the arsenic value was below 1, which is indicate the limit ability of this element to accumulate from the sediment. Meanwhile, this is the result of cockle length, weight, and trace metals concentration for both areas. The concentration of metal then was compared with the Food Safety Regulation, which is Ministry of Public Health, Thailand, 1986, and Malaysia Food Regulation, 1985. Therefore, it was observed that cadmium and lead concentration was exceeded permissible limit for both sites, especially in September. As conclusion, the cockle on both sides had higher accumulation of metal, especially in September. On the other hand, it found that there is strong correlation of cadmium with the cockle length in Batanic Bay and Still Wetland. Meanwhile, for the food safety regulation limit comparison, the mean value for all the trace elements was still within acceptable limit. However, the maximum value of cadmium and lead exceeded the limit for both areas. Therefore, regular monitoring of trace metals in cockle from both areas is necessary for more definitive contamination determination. And that's all from me. Thank you very much.